Fucking hey, Kyle, you even put a camera on the fucking back end?
Fuck yeah! Yeah, I can light back here too.
I see that.
I didn't have a backup camera. Hold on. Hold on. 72. Okay. All right, what's your strength set to? Oh, that's better.
You gonna finish this field, Kyle?
Probably. What does? What are you using? 32 or 28 or? Oh, yeah, I can't tell you. Might be fucked.
Am I supposed to be putting on 32?
Yeah, that's what I use. I don't know. You can use whatever the fuck you want. But what am I using? That's what you'd use in real life. It'd be 28 or 32. What do you normally put on, Eric? Like, a gallons an acre?
20. Some people I know, like, that guy at the feed yard, they put on like 70-some. But that's side starter and that, and they put on some dry, but they put on 70-some. I'm gonna be putting on 40. Or hell, I might even have you do it. Go put on 40 gallon at that fucking seed corn. Up at fucking up north.
But like, that's 130 acres on a fill.
Yeah.
It probably needs doubled the usage does. That'd be making hydrous about right too if we doubled it, wouldn't it? Remember?
Do what?
We were putting on anhydrous. It was about half the rate it should have been, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because you should only get with doubles if you're putting on 175 pounds. There's usually around, in a 1,000, there's usually about 3,400 pounds. Let's just say 6,800 pounds divided by 175 if you're putting on corn on corn ground. You'd get about 38 acres to a fill.
That one might even be higher than yet.
On doubles. I can usually get about 100, or I can usually get about 20 acres on. 20, 22 acres, depending if it's a 1500 though. There's usually about 5,100 pounds in them. So there's no way they're doubles are, I guess you can pull doubles. So there's 10,200 pounds divided by 175 pounds. It's 58 acres to fill.
Oh, I got a hand. Take some testing. Thanks.
Okay. Alright, well, I'm gonna get off, so I'll see you guys later.
Bye.
See ya.
The textures on the tractors need to be higher, guys. Like a res runner? Oh, wait, are you streaming? Oh, yeah, it's set to 0.0081. That's still higher than fertilizer, though. I don't know how precision farming works. If that's overwriting it, maybe there's a script that's telling it how many liters to use. I don't think so. I'll try it in single player one of these nights, see if I can fuck with it. Set the motherfucker to like 2 and see if it changes it with precision farming. If not, it's something in the mod. No, precision farming mod. See if the usage scale on the applicator does anything. Oh, the fucking in-game radio's got some fucking bangers. Fucking gambler? Does. What is this? The 181 FM country or whatever? Fucking bangers. Sprayer? What are you spraying? Oh. Fucking Dollar General sprayer. Are there actually people watching you? Whoa, are they talking?
Sorry.
Better go check this shit out.
And next month, or the end of this month, will be the Sunflower 6631-36 productivity tool. Because I just got some hillbilly to do soil animations for me. He's a hillbilly. And then later it'll be the John Deere 1775 with Furry Force and single disc fertilizer openers and a fertilizer tank and ridge marker options and weight options. And yeah.
Just screen quality that shit.
Yep.
I was like sitting here bumping it up like 1080p, 720p. It's all just shit.
It's all just shit. I know. Yeah. It's like the rest of me. Just shit. My mods, shit. Stream, shit. Just shit. My mods, shit. Stream,
shit. Can they even hear you? I can hear you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My anhydrous applicator release? I don't even have one. Not mine. I don't plan to put Nutrimax on there. That's not mine either. Unless Kyle wants a new gun or something.
I do want a new gun. Gonna have to double their... Everybody's gonna have to double their money.
Yeah. How many hours did you spend on this thing?
Yeah, what, you're going to charge by the hour here?
Yeah, I'll charge you 25 cents an hour.
Okay, well, it's been in progress for roughly 3.5 years.
Shit. fuck. Not good. Oh, shit. $7,600? That is sad, actually. He made $26 or 26 or 25 cents an hour and worked every single hour for 3.5 years at $7,600.
I could buy a new rifle.
No, TNA modding's Anhydrous Bar is not released.
It's hot, though. Get your shirt wonder.
Very nice. It took
very long. As long as you have an i9, 12900K and a 3090.
Yeah, otherwise it's junk.
Get the few polys. I don't know this on my computer, but
yeah, I don't need
people bitch about polys all the time, so
sure do. People bitch about everything.
You even got tanks between the tracks on there, man.
Yep, those are made by Kai. I can tell Roach that. I'm just kidding.
Need some tanks for these 8Rs.
Get the Demcos converted. Side
quest. Didn't they release them?
I don't fucking know.
Or did Tyson release? Tyson had them, didn't he?
I think, yeah. It should take like 30 seconds to convert.
Right?
Fucking tank.
Put the attachment on all the tractors.
Yeah, it'll take the longest time. Make a stand, buy some land, make some love, and them babies come.
Raise them up. You have an option on the tractor for the tank supports on the axles, because you never take those motherfuckers off.
Minnesota Farmer, I already did, so you can go back in the stream like 5 minutes.
You do that.
Yeah, you can just slide back.
Oh, yeah. Like.
There'd be more. Just look at my Facebook page. If it's not specifically posted on my Facebook page, it's not going to be on the Patreon. I don't just like. Well, there's some things on there that I haven't announced, but you'll just have to find out what that is. But don't buy it expecting everything I've ever made on there, because that's not how it goes. And I get a lot of messages every month, people who get very angry that I don't have thousands and thousands and thousands of hours on there every single month, because I can't do that.
Well, it doesn't like you're always working on your own stuff.
That is very true. Most of the coolest things I have done aren't mine.
I'll say the old fucking Nutramax is the best she's ever been.
Yep.
Not bad.
I don't know if I'll release the map. I'm not going to say yes. I'll leave it at that. It needs a lot of fucking work, and it's really not that good. It's just cool because it's big and it has one cool popular farm on.
That nobody uses.
That nobody uses, because it's not done, because I haven't finished it. It needs a lot of work, needs a lot of detail. Farms need to be rebuilt.
Want another map to work on?
No. I already have another map to work on. Now, Royalton, on the other hand.
I'm never going to be able to finish that map now.
Yeah. I doubt I'll be able to finish the map ever again. But I do want to finish Royalton and release it. Maybe.
Somebody already converted it.
Somebody did already convert it, but they made it worse. Miraculously, they made it worse.
Which is kind of surprising.
It's very surprising. Do I really want to release the Royalton map and then see my buildings be used and recycled and refabbed and refucked and monkey fucked and shit done and terribly?
That's the worst problem about releasing like one of our maps is there's like fucking 50 other mods that come with it.
Right.
If you don't have those, it's just a fucking empty map.
Pretty much. I should probably actually end up releasing the fertilizer plant. That's in demand. Pretty bad.
Yeah, I'd release my liquid shed too.
Wanna do it?
Yeah, I don't care.
Okay, I'll take a month this summer or something. We can do it.
I think both of those turned out pretty good.
Yeah, and they match, so may as well use them both. How many hours did you spend on that? Don't be a cunt. Then you're gonna say
I don't. That wasn't very much.
Yeah,
that was pretty quick. That might be the fastest mod I've ever made.
Truth. I probably should just release a bunch of them sheds that we made when 22 first came out.
Yeah, there you had a ton of sheds.
Yeah,
none of mine are worth a fuck, but
a whole bunch.
Here to find out, can we get Larson Farms top tier, your patron?
Yep.
Awesome. Thanks.
Yep.
I'll start advertising for you.
Yep. Yep.
Add top $1,000.
Bob always so quiet.
Yeah, I don't understand.
Why can't I stop? There we go. I love how we have a whole brand new game. A whole brand new GPS mod. It still does the same thing it did in 19.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, he's turned all the way up, too.
Is that better?
No.
I'm the quiet one. Come. Special guest for the live stream. We have Razors First. And his retarded brother.
Where has Razor been? I haven't heard anything out of that guy in a long time.
Work.
He's about like fucking Joe.
Who made the side dress bar? It's
Polygonish.
This meathead right here. Well, he edited it. Blender edited it.
Blender edited the shit out of it.
He blendered it 3 years ago.
You get it for $19.
Yep, $19, get the same thing.
Or you can just go convert the leak.
Yeah.
There's leak. Somebody already converted the shitty one, so.
They release it?
I don't know.
They better.
I've seen pictures of it a while back.
Yeah.
I see. Mine's got tracks and wheels, though, thanks to Owen.
Yeah. They both sink in the ground, thanks to me, also.
Unless it does the custom modding, I don't want it.
Yeah.
It doesn't move, though. It's that motherfucker's planted on the ground. Like the first one I've ever done with tracks on it that doesn't slide.
Bobby, your best buddy LBJ's back.
I seen.
Thoughts, feelings, opinions?
Well, I mean, I can't wait till he converts his Challenger, because then I can finally quit working on this one.
Custom modding?
No.
Are you custom modding?
Joe has the best challenger ever in farms.
Custom modding's not doing a challenger.
They're doing what?
They're doing a honeybee. Honeybee huh. header. 225 header. 260 header.
Weird.
Yeah.
So I could have sworn there was a picture of a cobble fucked motor with like a five-sided cube on the side of it.
Yeah. Console ready. How are they gonna get the cat logo on console?
They're not. They're just gonna have. They're gonna be like, "Sit." It's gonna say "dog," and then instead of power under, it's gonna say "shit."
Yeah. That'd be good.
But instead of shit, it's a line dot. So it'll pass.
Yeah. I guess I could brand it as fucking lizard. There's a cat dozer on the mod hub. I think if they just say it, that
they
it's
could
a lizard.
Probably, it'd just be Challenger, I'm sure, is what it'll be. But they have the cat logo on the front of it.
Yeah.
On the water pump housing or whatever.
And on the valve cover, it says cat on it.
I don't see it on the valve cover, but it should say like C18 on the back and accent something other. Whatever the fuck I got on the top of it, I don't remember. I was like, cool.
Oof. Don't set your quality to very high.
Why, what happens?
Eats FPS.
Oh, medium looks good.
Oh, yeah, there we go. What's the FPS count, though?
40.
6.
Yikes.
I don't even remember how to turn on my FPS gunner. There we go.
F2.
I got 50.
It's just kind of, like, bizarre 50, how you only need half your FPS for rendering, like, the entire map from going from nothing.
Yeah, low looks really good.
This guy shadows, I don't want it.
Tractor fades out of view. Shadows the fucking bin. The grain bins need a clip distance set on them.
Yeah,
you
do, bro.
You set it to low, your tractor disappears, but the grain bins are still there.
Not good.
Someone's got the 10 million fucking clip distance.
Whoever made the grain bins fucking sucks at modding. Wasn't me.
There's this guy on Facebook. It's OS Farms. He's really good at taking stuff and putting it into game. You should message him on Facebook.
Yep. Not doing that, but.
Yeah, don't take advice from that Wade Mitch guy.
Yeah, he's pretty stunned.
Or take advice from.
NDMM will in-game it for you. He will Maya smooth it and in-game it. And it'll look like it came from Haggy. Trust me.
I mean, Mega Supporter, it does say it comes with modding support.
You don't want your modding support. It's more emotional torture than modding support.
I never said it was good modding support, it's just modding support.
Don't you have to know how to mod before you get modding support?
No.
Fucking ask anybody.
MRG for the mapping tutorials, he doesn't know a fucking thing.
Knows all the things.
You ever got that Ash Corners done yet, or is that still like, we're sorry we haven't got this done because my hand cramped?
Yeah.
We're
gonna stream the Giants podcast.
No, I think we're actually at the third or even fourth time already.
Why Why is your fertilized color so much darker than mine?
I don't see color.
Well, like, I can barely tell where I've been. I can see it on your stream, like, plain as day. It's just your shitty fucking stream.
Shut up.
It's not a stream, you can see it.
320p.
I can see it perfectly. Kyle, it's your internet.
What's not?
Kyle, it's your internet.
Is that more important, Wade?
That's just Kyle on a daily, though. If you turn him down, then you can't ever hear him because he falls asleep.
I do.
And this, Kyle, you got some chips close to you by? We got to do some ASMR here.
Oh, I changed my settings. You can't hear me eat anymore.
Fuck. Bob, you got a pizza, mate? Your ASMR.
No, I ate some pizza rolls, but 20 minutes ago.
Fuck.
Not pizza rolls, fucking hot pocket thingies. It's kind of pizza and a roll, technically, too, ain't it?
Yeah, same shit.
You know, not all sliced up.
Not all sliced up like a liberal's. No, I'm just kidding. Just kidding.
Hey, don't call your number one fan in your chat a liberal. From Minnesota.
Shut up.
Hey, if you're a mega supporter to my patron, I will give you a West Farms address. Then you can just show up at his house and he will have to help you mod.
I will give you Robert.
Wait a minute. His mom's address or his dad's address? Because
I got two asks, but fuck off. I'll be up north on next week, so you don't know where that is either.
Royalton, baby.
Royalton. Downtown Royalton.
I'm tired.
I'm tired of you, bitch. I wonder if I can live stream from a drone POV. That'd be kind of cool, I think.
I mean, you probably could. You'd have to run it through some other software, you know, and like kind of some. I don't know how. I'm sure you could do it.
You want to do what?
Stream drone POV.
Oh, that would be cool. That would probably be the shitty resolution that you get on your phone or whatever when you're.
Kaya working for you again?
Yeah, Kaya planted this field. For sure, I wasn't the one running the corn planter the whole time that I just spent like 3 weekends working on.
Damn, you worked 3 weekends fixing up a case planter?
Yep,
behind us, he's a DB120.
Not probably you, bro.
But Joe's got it.
Joe do got it. Go get it.
You can get a 1/32 scale X9. But that's cheap. That's not bad, $150.
Ridge markers on this thing.
You know, I know the guy who to message if you want any of Joe's stuff.
Who?
Kyle's BFF.
Fuck you, Kyle.
I don't know who he's talking about.
So. Which BFF? He's got so many. And they're all so terrible. Dylan DeLong? That they hate each other.
Nah, I mean, Dylan could suck his way back into a circle, I'm sure.
Dylan can suck pretty hard, like it owes him money.
How would you know, Owen?
Because he's playing with them on a server.
He's playing on my daddy server.
And he's never contributed anything other than a half finish truck.
Two half, three half finish trucks.
I was calling them all the same, so
yeah. Yeah, who forgot to use the fucking raid controller here too? Dumbass.
Nice landing. Who planted an angle?
Huh?
Who planted at an angle?
Did an Hydrocent angle. Jit.
Don't normal people do anhydrous straight with the rows and then you plant right on top of the row where you put the anhydrocent?
No.
Nope. Thought that was one of them poverty things.
Yeah. That's all you, Kyle.
What?
It's gonna be you.
That's right. Let's sit in a brand new tractor and do it.
Ridge Rose gonna hurt your vag, bro, if you run over.
What the fuck is so special about that thing?
What?
Oh, it's an employee edition. That's cool. Oh, an employee edition X9 combine.
Oh.
Kyle, you don't need more shit to move, you idiot.
What? I'll have it delivered to the new house. Fuck.
It'll get lost. It'll end up in Eric's house.
Oh, you can get the 1/32 scale class Lexion 8900 combine, high detail.
How you gonna pay for
$65. I already have the good internet. And I don't have to pay for shit.
Do they have an STS?
Dude, you can get a fucking Rogator.
You have an STS?
I
don't
they know. Used to make a 9750.
Yeah, I have one.
I need to make the 50 series. Engine cover. And headlights and interior.
They still, 164. Yeah, they make a 1/32 scale, 9880.
Well, what year?
9870.
Yeah. The new style or old style?
Oh.
They're gonna make the really old.
Yeah, the really old one.
Yo, like Owen, 95 bucks. You can have a 1/32 scale 9870 STS combine.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it good?
I don't know. It's from like 1995, so.
And you're a piece of shit.
94, Owen, get it right.
How was the person with dementia remember what year they were born?
Right? He's just like his president. He got dementia, he's retarded, can't ride a bike.
Oh, you can get the 9750 with an 8-row, man.
I want that.
That's kind of cool. Precision Series, $215.
Yeah, there's the fan. That's the nice one.
That's the fancy one.
That's the Turbo Squid one.
Yeah, that's the better than Turbo Squid one, probably.
Bullshit. I do want to make the late model 1670 series, pretty much the same thing, except for the engine and the decals. And then the early 50 and 60 are pretty much the same thing, except for the decals and the engine. And there's like a middle fucking 60 series. Fuck that. I just want the 50 and 70. I don't give a shit about 60.
Well, the early 70s and 60s were about the same. Some of the early 50s, I think, they had different rear stuff, too.
Oh, yeah, they had a different structure.
But some are even walkers, too. Like if it's
I think it was just the 90, the 9550 was the only one you could get with walkers.
Yeah.
It's like, when those first came out, fucking everybody in Ohio had a walker machine. They're all like, we can finally get rid of our 9500. I could get damn near run a 30-foot head on one of them.
Hope you could run a 30-foot head on one. You don't want a 50 series, so they have problems breaking and like the cross augers in the tank and bearing some electrical
engines.
Wow, those are only $69,000. It's not that big of a deal.
Well, combines were $69,000.
Anymore, it's just cheaper to buy a new combine or buy another combine than just replace an engine. I just slow down. Mud bog out here. Wait, Mitch gets it. Nope. Squirrel.
It looks like it's a blower and they're chopping the corn stalks that go in there and blowing them into like a wagon.
What if it isn't? Oh yeah, that's one of those fucking, what do they call them fucking things? You can get like a baler you can pull behind your combine too.
Horse torques.
I think they had it advertised at John Deere. Last time I was in there, you could, like, I think Hilco makes a baler kit.
Kyle, you said a 9750 should be able to run a 30 foot?
A 9550. A 9750 ought to be able to run like a 35, I would think.
Yeah, I think this is a little, might be a little push on this old girl.
Oh my. Fuck, did you get like a hydraulic fucking jack underneath of it? You sit on her and jack it up to raise the head up?
It's got lift assist.
No, they probably got the triple cylinder aftermarket bolt on.
It does have lift assist wheels. Oh my god.
Oh, it does. It's fucking sweet.
Great.
As for that 20 bushel corn, that thing could eat it at like 2 mile an hour.
Never seen a corn head with lift assist wheels. I guess they're not really lift assist wheels, but they are wheels. But
they're probably in hills or something too to try to keep it out of the ground. I mean, it looks pretty flat, but
probably in North fucking Dakota, just like everything else that's retarded.
At least so you don't bust the final drives off the fucking combine. See if you can find more pictures of it. I guarantee there's a full rack of suitcase weights hanging on the.
I don't know if they do a full, it's not a case.
Oh, right. They're pretty light.
Have you ever been in a case?
Yes. Good to fill our back tires on our S680 with fluid because it back tires are coming up off the ground in the hills.
What's your problem for farming in hills?
You can't all farm flat ground.
Yeah, you can. You just have to move.
I'm not moving to North Dakota.
You know, I didn't quite find a picture of that again, but that's a fucking hill for a combine.
That's pretty good.
And is that fucking sunflower?
How do you make that work? Like,
how the fuck do you go back down?
They did make a 9750 with a walker machine. I didn't know you could go that big with a walker machine.
That's Europe. Look, the Europe always gets the oddball versions stuff.
Oh yeah, it's probably like a 9650 or a 9550.
They always sold everything with different decals over there too.
Yeah, that's impressive. What are them? Are sunflowers, aren't they?
It looks like it.
They're pretty shitty. Whatever it is,
it isn't very good.
Probably don't need to be farming the side of the hill.
But I mean, I'm sure they still made a ton of money off it. I mean, flowers pay good.
That. Six row life. This series life.
Series with a six row. That's an eight.
That's an eight?
Yeah.
Oh, lame.
Got duels on it. You can't run duels with a six row.
You can run some small duels with a six row.
What?
You can run duels with a six row. It's gotta be small.
You're gonna knock corn off with your duels.
There you go, bitch.
Yeah, you can't. It shouldn't say you can't run duels with a six row. You shouldn't run duels with a six row. Those aren't duels.
No, but it's a six row.
It's a six row on an S series count, but probably an S550.
No.
There's a guy up here who's got a S780 on a fucking with an eight row corn head. Brand new Aero.
They look sweet. I want to make one for Armson.
And the side panels are ready.
Really good.
Halfway there. I don't want to make a folding 12 row head.
Bingo, I found it. You can click it and look, see where it's at.
Like, that is not the type of picture that I would put on something if I was selling it. Like.
How the fuck did you find this?
Where's Howard, USA?
You click on the thing, it's in South Dakota.
That explains it. Just open the game again.
And they're damn near neighbors with Kyle. That's damn near Sioux Falls.
I wonder how much work it would take to get the...
That belt is on 16 row for a 50 series.
I wonder how hard it would be to take the in-game folding 16 row and chop her down to a fucking folding 12 row.
And how Cobblefuck would be on it.
Well, I don't really care how Cobblefuck it is.
Does it fold in the same spot and the elders are just different?
No.
Or do you actually have to move one row at the inside too?
Six in eight center and three on either side. And this one's eight in the center and four?
What did you say? Oh, yeah. And you'd have to change the feeder house size too.
Yeah, fun with that.
That's just. Those are just filler plates. You just have to make filler plates to fill in there because that's all they do. It's not a bad looking card.
There's like CF or something.
C12F. Stretch.
They make an 8 roll folding.
Yep.
If you can't get down the road with a fucking 8 roll, you probably don't need to get there.
It's not designed for being out here, it's designed for like New York and shit.
But it's fucking like 2 feet wider than the fucking tires of the combine.
Yeah, but. Sometimes the tires barely fit.
I wrecked that a lot.
The new style header, did they change anything with the deck plates? Like the chopping system?
I don't think so.
What the sides of the new one?
Do what?
What the sides of the new one on the old header?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you probably could.
Because you have the hydraulic little spinner thing. for your Pioneer Corn Picker Upper.
Eight row folding corn. That is something.
What in the D-long feed lot?
So you got what, five snoots that stay solid in the center, and then the third one from each end fold, like, rotates up a little bit.
Should we go look at those junk things sometime? See what else I forgot, missed, or needs fixing?
Sure.
On what?
None of your business.
Oh.
Test them out on this dedicated server, because I got some wheat harvest to do.
That's how you end up with leak stuff.
It is a Kinsey, and Dylan is on this server, so I will refrain from that. Does this one work with the AGI DLC?
I don't know. Maybe. Maybe not. No clue.
Yeah.
Can't say. Haven't really used it for more than 5 minutes. I don't know how the fuck that conflicts either, but... Oh, we found the Owen Snubby Corn Header. We found it. Kyle, you ready?
I'll be a fucking... What is that thing? A Fantini or something stupid?
The logo's an FE.
That's what Kai had.
It's on them stupid... narrow row ones where you can cut across the rows with it.
Base Kansas City area.
Look at the back tires in that combine. The fuck are
those? I know, there's so much road shit going on. What the fuck is sticking out the back by the auger?
The second auger. But it's got like new style flashers on it. The fuck?
Corn is like 2 feet tall.
Oh, you want a 32 row corn head? They got one of those too.
I don't want one.
I don't want anything that looks like that.
Oh, no, it looks better. It almost looks like a John Deere that someone made in FS15.
What brand is it? Is it Fantini or is it?
That other one was a. Manardo? I don't. E100? Must be European.
And the big one's a Calmer, isn't it?
Yeah. Tom Cornhead.
Yeah.
Hero. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of the. One of the United States when it went to Kansas.
I'm not a big fan of the single gathering chain. I think Geringhoff makes a...
What, 10 years ago, I think they had a narrow one.
They
but
still
do.
Yeah. Yeah, but I'm pretty sure they. I don't know if they go.
5 degree angled one.
Yeah, they're at an angle. Are they? Was it a 20-inch head or was it a 30 or a 15-inch head?
I think it was a 20 with dual. Maybe, or a 50 or both. I just remember they filed the patent for the 45-degree chain.
Yeah, the slimline gathering system. Gathering chain guides set on a 45-degree angle allow for two chains per row on a very narrow configuration for harvesting 15-inch row spacings.
Is there anyone that plants 15-inch corn?
There's a couple guys around here plant 15-inch corn.
Silage or actual, like, grain?
Grain. There's the one over here plants for silage, but there's one down by the city that plants it for grain.
I guess you shouldn't have to worry about weed control after about fucking 2 weeks.
Yeah, it closes the rows up extremely fast.
And it also probably quits growing fast, too.
I don't know. I think it does pretty good. The silage corn does really good.
Well, I'd assume, because the silage, you don't need the fucking to actually finish and grow.
I don't know. It's just as tall as the 30-inch corn, usually, and tons out just as good. Got good ears on it. Is it Geringhoff that has the deck plates that are spring loaded?
That's Drago.
What is it, Drago?
Oh, don't ask Dylan. He will tell you all about it. Because they got the good corn in the bottom and the shitty corn on the hills.
They have adaptive flex on their head, dude.
Hearing off?
Yeah.
That wasn't that, what, 2 years ago maybe?
I don't know, you can get a folding, chopping, flexible. 20 to 40 inch spacing head.
Hey, you farm in the hills. How many places would you actually need a flexing corn head?
Oh, a lot.
Make it chop better, or just the actual picking ears better?
No, to get the ears.
I suppose if it flexes with the ground, it picks up that pioneer corn pretty good when it's tipped over.
I don't know how the guys with the 16 row heads are getting much younger. Like, they gotta leave a lot of corn on the fields. I know the hinge drapers are big sellers around here this year. Fucking Wayne has got a bunch of them over there.
These of you really got them viewers going.
Yeah.
So who's the last fucker in here watching?